live. So, yeah, they know Oregon like the back of their hands. So pretty excited for that.
Let's see what you guys think about who will win this, as this should be pretty contested here. And it is. Although favoring FaZe, I'm not too surprised given the performance of the end of last season. But at the same time, you never know. Liquid have made changes since then.
So. Yeah, we'll see if there will be enough. Now, a lot of people have been talking about the Liquid Super Team, their creation of a team that is a bit that functions a bit more as a squad together. Gohan's addition to the team is definitely something that has seen some fruit, and obviously in BR6 is very present. A DreamHack, it wasn't really the case, DreamHack Winter, but still, there's definitely a squad to look out for, and we'll see how they face off against their better rivals in the region. There's no way around it. This is as much of a grudge match and a hometown derby as it's ever going to get.
Yeah. Well, let's see what they end up banning out here as far as operators. Should be interesting to see what we're not going to see here on Oregon. Always find this part interesting to see if they bring some random ideas. Capitao being banned is
makes sense.
Is unusual in the sense that it doesn't happen very often, but as you said, it is something that does make sense in terms of the way he's used very usefully on both bomb sites. So, although I feel like it's been a long time since we've seen an attempted Dorms B push with the Capitao Firebolt being part of that. It's just not been a
usually
thing.
When it happens, it happens from the hallway itself.
Yeah.
Not from the windows. Thatcher's going to be banned. Adami? Valkyrie. Ooh.
Definitely a pretty common ban now. Probably catching up with Echo in terms of one of the more banned operators.
Makes sense. Valkyrie. A lot of people are like, oh, yeah, but, you know, these other operators, they have cameras as well. Yeah, but Valkyrie functions in a different way. Again, side grades, people.
Yeah, I feel like IQ play is dropping a slight amount this season. And that might also, you know, factor into that is people that don't want to have to bring IQ just with that. And rather than the mute, the bandit.
Bandit? This is the first time bandit gets banned. Jaeger as well was banned once.
Interesting choices.
Last night, the Jaeger. Oh, well, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, it was banned last night.
Hmm.
It was interesting.
Thinking. All right, well.
Processing.
Trying to process.
Computing.
I'm not that kind of a... I know I'm a bot, but not that kind of a bot.
I didn't say it.
We'll see how this goes here, as I wouldn't be too sold on the Maverick being played in this situation.
Well, there's the mute coming out. But the Ying play... We used to see a decent amount of Ying bans occasionally on Oregon.
I don't get why the Twitch switches to the Ying and then the Maverick stays in. They're probably going to be attacking Laundry. I mean... Yeah, I mean, the hatches in the meeting hall are not always going to be reinforced. Or usually they're even taken down.
Usually one is and one's not.
Yes, so the Maverick would make sense because then the Thermite, you know, he'd only need one of his charges to do the work, which is basically just in the lobby. But in most cases, if you can...
But Habana's not banned.
Exactly. This is the drama that we have right now. The drama as in the conundrum that we're facing. If you want a flexible Heart Breacher, when you know you're not going to destroy walls, what's the point of bringing the Thermite? Because Thermite is more, I will destroy a whole wall, open up the thing.
It's I mean, if it's like, hey, we might want to come from blue, all right. I can get on board with that. But you know they might have a mute jammer for that anyways. Like, you're still going to have to deal with that. But you have the Maverick, I guess. If they're going to go for a blue push.
Nah, tower push. This is what makes sense.
Yeah.
They have to clear the tower just in case there's anyone in there. And... Lucifer, that's what we were mentioning. That's Palu. It'd be great if people didn't change their names, but cameraman will just enter in the tower and there's nobody to contest them.
I mean, that's good that he's able to get in there quickly. The question is, are they going to turn that into anything? It is weird to have the Ying kind of leading the way unless he's going to use it semi-roam clear. In the sense, you usually want to have a Ying play a bit back because you're going to be using it more so for the execute unless you're using it for roam clear. But in this case, if he thought it was safe to take T3 and he's just going to take it, hold it for now while Astro goes down there and helps with roam clear, this is not the worst strategy to be employing at all. But as I say that, Nesk, nicely done.
Yikes.
That feels bad.
Yeah. That's definitely not something you'd like to...
That's partially why you hold the Ying back.
And you lose the Ying, you lose a lot of potential utility play. Of course, the Ying is only really going to do work later on as the Candelas have been used. And the Ash map, in the meantime, is just looking around, droning around, and still hasn't really found anything. As you see, the Mute Jammers even put upstairs will affect the drones below.
Yeah.
Because, you know, it's a cone, it's a cylinder, not a cone. Cylinder. And Ness will go maybe for a second peek in here. He's awaiting any information from his teammates. But of course, you don't have the Valkyrie, so you cannot use that to your advantage. Now, what Nesk usually plays is that Valkyrie, especially on Oregon.
Can't now.
Can't now. Well, the Legion is definitely doing work early on. And at least he's putting up and setting up his goo mines as swiftly as spawn.
Still gets intel, just in a different way.
Very true. Side grades.
Side grades, yeah. That's your, that's your new theme. It's like the developers in non-binary. It's just one of those.
It does make sense, you know? Yeah. Impact frags with Kix's thing, and now it's gonna, you know, this is gonna be mine. Paul is gonna find one. Astra will be removed from play. I'm not sure where actually he got him. Was it just like on staircase?
This is an interesting smoke attempt. I mean, I assume he rotated based off what he saw, but it...
Yuna just walks on in and he finds the kill! Sexy Kid going down! He's so low on health, though.
And still worth it.
I don't know if there's enough time to go for a reset in this case. Moringa will come in right behind Maverick. They'll both try to attack from the tower side. Palu is still alive and really bumping here, so he can drop down the stairs and fight ASAP. Now, Mirror Window is set on a soft wall, and it's actually opened up from below. The flash will come in from Mavis, drops in, fires in the back, only hits the shoulder of Zixmira.
That was definitely close to a head, but wow.
Wow! Paul from above, he'll find one, Nesk with another, and Gohan as well, one from the back.
Nice
spot laundry. Moringa goes down, and Team Liquid find a pretty swift first round.
It was a bit spread out, too. They had a lot of people upstairs, but it seemed to work out very well because FaZe, they started losing people on that attack. First the Ying, then the Dokubi. As they started losing people, they lost manpower. Then they just then could not focus on the roam clear they wanted to do, so they didn't clear anything. They instead just focused solely on let's get into blue and get this rolling because we're getting low on time. We've got to kill the smoke. The smoke did a great job delaying them. I mean, it's an odd way to play it, but it certainly worked in terms of doing a good job delaying them as long as possible so everyone else could be in good positions. It was just it was not a great series of plays. It was interesting to see, again, a Thermite with a Claymore instead of flashbangs.
Yeah, that is a bit of an oddity. But one thing I would like to remind everyone is that with the rule set changed, I feel that we have to say this for the first couple of weeks of play,
yeah.
Is that now, to win the game, you need to put 7 rounds up on the board. If you put 6, that's still not enough. You're in map and match point, but you need that 7th one. Of course, before you won, once you hit, once you got those 6 rounds, now you need an extra one. You can still tie at 6-6, but before it was 5-5.
Yeah.
So those 2 rounds increased have actually dramatically reduced the amount of ties that we've gotten. And I will be looking for the number of comparison ties within the first 3 play days of all the regions between season 8 and 9.
I know there was a lot of ties, I believe, at the beginning of Latin America season 8.
That's not just because we were all looking to be down.
That has to be the problem. I'm pretty sure that's what the stats are based on, right? Interesting setup here. Again, a very heavy defense here inside the kitchen to be able to hold from below to make sure no one can stop. Again, we're going to see the Ying brought out, but this time we're going to see a sledge being brought out. But still, again, the Thermite and the Maverick. And again, they have the choice of something else if they want to, although I feel like Latin America generally has run a lot more Thermite than other regions that have focused a bit more on Habana, so it is a little bit more in meta to be doing so. Unfortunately, it looks like Moringa might have gotten stuck, or we might have had a delay here.
No.
Yep, looks like they might have got disconnected. They probably are in a team house, as many of the Latin American teams are, and may have just all lost internet in their team house at once, which we've seen Ninjas in Pajamas suffer from at least twice.
I'm not sure if there was like a storm or the cat came in and pulled out the plug, but did you?
At least Zig giving out the good game well played. So
yeah, we'll remind you, it's not done.
No.
So
yeah, it's not.
We're just going to wait. Only one round in, so we're waiting until we get some information, and then we can continue on later with the matchup. We're waiting for the rehost. We're waiting for FaZe to hopefully not have any problems, any major problems.
Well, it was an interesting start, at least the very first round. It was very Liquid dominated. That early kill by Nesk was definitely very good, killing the Ying. That was I don't think they saw that coming, that wall being soft. They just assumed it was not a big deal. You know, it's just a normal soft wall.
Mm-hmm.
Surprise, surprise to them. The tower take is always a nice idea, but it was a little bit slow in execution, and the droning you can't drone up into the attic very effectively if they've not opened it up on the other side for you to do so. And in that case, most of the time, they're going to catch your drone. So it is interesting.
Gun is tapped.
What's that?
And then the Ying Gun is the tap.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, face checking it also not as effective. But it is interesting, though, in that there's only so many things you can do about that.
I mean, phase checking it.
Phase, there you go.
There you can continue. There. I was
the Ying got phased out. Liquefied. Either way. What can you do when you're waiting to go back to round two? At least it shouldn't take a lot of time to recreate, just because, well, it's just one round.
I just hope that there's no, like, major technical issues.
Yeah, there's definitely the case that we could have a while before FaZe is able to come back if it is a full internet drop.
We are definitely waiting for an update here from our admin and production team. So once we have that and I'll be able to go, I'm not sure if we have any information. It might be a full disconnection that, you know, was caused by a storm or something. I'm not sure. I believe all the players from FaZe Clan live in Sao Paulo. So... I'm not sure if there was anything huge that was going on or not.
Well, hopefully they are able to get back online as quickly as possible and get back into the game. But it is definitely going to be the case where that could slightly break the momentum of Liquid. But it is, you know, when it's only run round in, that's not going to make a huge difference. If anything, they can look for any mistakes they made that round, think about them, what they could do better. So in the meantime, though, we will have Liquid for sure getting back in.
Yeah, we're just waiting until FaZe Clan gives us some sort of information in the meantime. I'm just waiting to rehost in the meantime. So, of course, when the rehost, you should have to input the information for the round that was just played. And, of course, we played in Laundry, which resulted in victory for the defense. So, I'm not sure. They obviously cannot play this again here, Team Liquid.
Yeah, no, it's definitely going to be a case where they're going to be up in dorms. With being a rehost anyways, they're going to have to play the same bomb site that they chose. So same operators as well means FaZe, if they were able to get some idea what was going on, but I mean, it was so fast into the round. Like, I don't know how much intel they were able to gather from their drones early on. But either way, they know that tower might be clear to an extent if they're able to swing into it successfully next time.
I hope they check the attic again.
I do hope so. And as I was saying, it is difficult to get in there because you have to think about there's walls on both sides unless they're purposely opened up by the defense. I think you used to be able to jump your drone somewhat effectively up the ladder from Meeting Hall, but I feel like that's gotten more difficult towards impossible over time or just so time-consuming as to not be worth it.
You used to be able to clip it on the side.
It was almost like you were getting on the bolts on the side of the ladder.
That's exactly how it would work. You would clip the side of the bolts as you went all the way up, but it's so time-consuming. And if you messed up once, you're back to square.
Same with getting up tower as well to T3. So, I mean, two components of tower are difficult to drone because they're ladder-based. And that's why you see T3 always being such a problem because you have to open a window and throw a drone in manually.
And they're usually like spotted at least.
Shoot right away. Up. You know someone's there, but you don't know where. It's tricky. It's tricky.
All right. One of the complications of life. We're still waiting.
Yeah, hopefully FaZe not too problematic to get back in.
They're not phased out.
Yeah. Liquid were able to get back in quickly, though, so that is definitely a good start.
They were very fluid in their way back into the lobby.
So hopefully FaZe get back quickly so we don't make any more puns.
Yes, please.
Going to dry up here sooner or later.
No, we already played Laundry.
Oh, well, okay. Way to parlay the Liquid joke, but it's fine. It's fine.
So, hey, it's just a rebuttal.
Okay, that's fine. I think...
It is a problem for us to, like, try to fill in with only one round.
Well, yeah, when you only have one round, it's like, what is there to say other than what
really.
We already said? I do hope that FaZe are going to be a little bit more thorough in their approach next time in terms of coming in knowing where people are at a little bit better. You know, are they able to actually get in... without being shot in the face, for example, and knowing where people are at, or at least coming in from an approach where they can secure it. So.
That's very smart. That's where you're the analyst. Now, interesting part is that Valkyrie is banned. So because there was this Valkyrie ban, you would expect it to have a big effect on Nesk, who's also recently voted as the best esport player in Brazil. You know, makes sense, right? He's pretty darn good. So with that Valkyrie ban, it does slow him down a bit, but when he played the Legion in the very first round, which is the only one we've had so far, he was already able to do a lot of damage. Not only to get the kills, but one thing about Legion that is... it kind of propagates to other operators as well, where you know that your opponents are not, you can actually determine where they are.
Yeah, to an extent, if they haven't like stepped on your goo mine, then you know you're not. They're not at that spot, which is why you generally put it at choke points, right? You want to put it in choke points in hallways, doorways, places where you know that if they have not stepped there, they have not entered that room potentially or gone down that hallway.
So you don't have to think about it.
It's a map control function, basically. So, luckily, we have some word that FaZe is going to be able to get back in here soon.
Yeah,
I believe there's a power outage.
There was a power outage from what we got in terms of information. So I hope it was, you know, just someone's cat playing around with the cables.
You and this cat thing. I don't know if they actually have a cat here. If you only live in a team house, is it like a team cat at that point?
I would like to have a cat. You know.
Oh, apparently, this is you project.
Or like. Any pet.
So it could unplug your power, apparently. So you don't have to do it. Like, turn off the lights for me. I'm going to bed.
Meow.
That's how it works.
I haven't had a pet since I was like 9 years old. I miss it. Problem is, if I don't, I can't have a pet right now because I live here in Katowice, and you know, it's a bit inhumane to just, you know, have a pet over where you travel a lot or have really weird schedules.
Yeah, no, it's definitely problematic. I had a hamster I had to leave behind.
Really?
And eventually died. Such a tragic story. They don't live too long.
Can we get some Fs in chat?
Yeah.
What did you call them? Or it?
Hamster.
Hamster?
Very creative. They don't live long. You replace them often. You're just like, you're hamster V4, whatever.
You are a programmer, aren't you?
Well,
it does show.
At least I'm not going to go Bird Box level and call my kids boy and girl. So, I'll try
it.
With actual names there.
I haven't watched it.
Oh, spoiler. No, not really. But we do have FaZe starting to get back in, so that's a good start.
Yes.
Hopefully. But we do have some word. Interestingly enough, it is a 2-0 for Liquid, as I assume that is the case because it was after
ruling.
Prep FaZe. They disconnected. It was no fault of Liquid's. So, you know.
This is basically how the rule book enacts
it. Yeah, and it was a case where, of course, they didn't all choose to quit, but they are gone, so.
I know some people will be mad about it, but the rules are rules. I would try to enforce them.
Well, we got 3 out of 5. Getting there.
2 more.
Yeah. So, the dorms attack here. I mean.
Capital is banned.
Yeah, so this becomes a little trickier. So they have the Ying, which is either often going to be coming from the armory side and coming from there and going for the Candelas to be able to blind, even potentially to plant a bunk,
actually,
depending on how you play it.
One thing I wonder is that if this counted as a death win.
Oh, that's right. Then they can't
then
play
they can't
dorms
play
again.
It.
Ooh, spicy.
Then they choice. Have to play Tower or Kitchen.
Hmm. I hadn't thought about that aspect yet. They are going to have to play Tower. And that was something you were talking about, the way the round counts work and stuff now. That also means good chance of having to see Tower twice per defensive side if they're winning their other defenses.
Or Kitchen once and Tower another time.
Yeah. So
possible.
Definitely right. Possible.
We are just ready to go in. We're going to verify that everything is up and running before we bring the camera onto Oregon. Mm-hmm. So just going to make sure we're going to play.
But,
ooh, Kitchen.
Ooh, yeah, Kitchen Dining instead, so this should be spicy. I got to imagine they were, if you're FaZe, you're expecting them to have been cooking up something in Tower instead.
They're going to cook it in Kitchen.
that was the joke. Too subtle. Too subtle. Sometimes you got to.
Subtlety is not my strength.
Sometimes you got to signal a little, I suppose.
Let's just say you got to build a runway to tell me that, hey, this is actually happening.
Right.
It's like.
Yeah.
Come here, taxi on this side.
Interestingly enough, they're going to fake with the IQ, but actually bring in the Finca. Now, this
Jack
is something that FaZe, we're the first team to really start bringing Finca. We actually started seeing G2 doing it in
but
recent play days.
Here's the big difference. G2 would run it alongside a Blitz.
Well, of course.
Which always makes a lot of sense.
It always surprises me when you don't see other teams doing that because, I mean, I guess if you don't have a good Blitz player, but there's so many good Blitz players in Latin America.
Please don't do that. Please don't.
So,
both of them?
Can
we not have?
Are going with the Ying and the Dokubi, as well as the double hard breachers, and then the Finca, of course, is kind of the extra one. And a Doc on the team this time. Yeah, definitely a good choice.
The doc makes a lot of sense. You know, obviously have the 2 evil eyes, but on top of it, you also bring the extra bulletproof camera. I'm not sure if Paulo is bringing it in this situation because we can't just say, hey, MarCU, can you switch around to it? But
yeah.
I wonder why they're not reinforcing at least one side of the wall. I know that, you know, leaving half of it soft makes a lot of sense, but, you know, all of it.
You really don't want to give them anywhere to plant because no one else is going to plant. I mean, you're not going to plant anywhere else generally. That being said, if you can really cover with smoke from the doorway and they can't be at the edge of kitchen very well, ooh, nice deployable shield position as well to be able to hold against exactly what cameraman's
There's
doing.
There's two of them in play, actually. Interesting. All right, well, ooh, what? Oh! Okay.
So there's the Finca boosting herself.
Yeah, and of course, if you're playing Finca, it makes a ton of sense to just use the LMG.
This is one gun where the recoil reduction is not going to mess you up. Unfortunately, Nesk not able to land the shots, but still good to taunt them a little because you can always rotate back because they're not on this side. But
you gotta worry.
Wow, they are fighting that long angle though.
Mav has all that he requires. Of course, he also has an extra drone there to give him info. I believe one. So it's an explosion. Don't know if that was the wall being opened up as focus right now is on Nesk.
I gotta say though, losing the Maestro early before you can adjust this camera at all to be able to kind of adapt to whatever's going on, definitely problematic. I mean, in general, the Maestro is needing to live a lot longer. Looks like we're gonna see what the Candela is used for as the kill on Dokubi goes off.
Ah, nicely done there from Gohan, and that's a pretty good way of landing the Candela inside, but you need to actually push behind it. And this is just a random Candela being thrown in. There was.
I mean, technically, you only need one for the plant, but at the same time, like, you want coverage. You need to make sure you blind everyone.
But there was no move after it.
Yeah. It was definitely a case of just trying to clear dining. They were just trying to push everyone out of dining so they could start to position. But it also, again, they weren't ready to go for anything. Gohan almost dying due to the grenade, it seemed.
Just chucking the grenade forward, and it's just to blow up that that shield. Moringa, in the meantime, will be able to come in and go for the plant. But the wall is soft next to him, so Gohan, all he's got to do is just move on in and go for the fight, and there you go, he'll land it. Nesk with one more, pistol in hand as Gohan will try to go for one more, but it's Paulu to find the MP5 shot on Mav and finish things off here. Team Liquid with a third round on the board.
I gotta imagine they were hoping to have a smoke for that from the Maverick, but the Maverick having died earlier left them without a smoke, and of course, they overplayed their Candelas early, giving them no way to cover themselves for that plant. And as you mentioned, the two deployable shields as well also help protect them from getting blinded. Let's say they tried to roll it down the hallway to try and blind the Rook. Well, that wouldn't have worked, and the Rook is the one who got the kill, so. Now, they are going to bring what looks like the similar attack, but they definitely are not going to be attacking tower or dining. Back to laundry we go, and no surprise there. So that is Liquid now with a third round on the board. They are
now they can go
well.
Back to laundry.
Yeah,
which is good. Definitely is a change of pace, right?
Yeah, it was interesting to see a dining defense that seemed to work. Some of that was due to some of the plays from FaZe, maybe not just being the most effective ones, but some of it was also losing players that they needed for that play. I mean, they had a nice early kill though onto Zig on the Maestro though. That was a good start for them. They had the advantage, but. Now that it looks like they could be going with double smokes as they're bringing a Jackal and a Maverick, although there's no guarantee that that's the utility they're bringing on those. And then they are going to have the Twitch for some of the utility to potentially clear anything out or just, you know, for the gun. Astro, being a very, very good Twitch player, he was kind of the premier Twitch player, I would say, for a while.
He did lose, you know, his first drone.
Yeah,
this is great out.
His headphones were on backwards. Attackers
are moving to defuse the bomb.
old reference directly for Ask.
Yeah, I remember that. That was hilarious.
I believe that was Gamescom.
Yes, that was Gamescom 2017.
Yeah, that was funny. It was just one of those examples where as soon as he turned his headphones on the correct
like,
way,
oh,
just
now I can hear everyone.
After that, yeah, that was all it was. Shoe was on the wrong foot.
You kind of noticed that though. The shoe part.
I would hope so.
Well, more Mewtwo.
FaZe, unfortunately, was most likely another power outage again. It was into the round again, so there's a good chance they could lose the round, but it's up to the admins to decide that. Certainly not up to us. But it's definitely not looking good for FaZe because, well, they were already behind. So it was three rounds, one of those lost due to a power outage, and possibly another one that could put them at a 4-0 deficit already.
Which definitely wouldn't be great. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We hope that the technical problems are fixed. Of course, FaZe have had a bit of a hiccup in the power.
Yep.
I haven't checked the weather reports either, so...
Still, you had 5 minutes.
I'm gonna blame it on the cat. Yeah, we're just checking that everything's running correctly here in Oregon. Remind you, it's a 4-0 for Team Liquid.
Yep, as they are going to dorms now because they technically won laundry.
There you go.
So, that's good. We are back, so that is also good in itself.
In control.
Yeah. So, we'll be faking the Pulse, but then bringing out the Maestro. It's good to see the different players could play the Maestro as well, because Zig playing it before, but Gohan playing it now. And I don't say that in the sense of, like, only one player can play one role, but it always is nice to see the flexibility in the teams. We are going to see the Finca again, this time with a Sledge and Zofia. So they're bringing a little bit different utility. It means they're still going to be getting extra grenades. So they're going to have 4 grenades, plus the 2 that can be shot out of the lifeline. Mm-hmm. So that's a lot of grenades on board. Then they've got the 2 hard breachers. Again, I have a feeling that the Thermite probably is bringing a Claymore and the Maverick on smokes, which means they have nothing except for Zofia's concussions, potentially, or the grenade ones, I suppose, if you want to use those, to clear ADSs. I know we harp on that a bit, but it is important. As you can see, well, Jaeger on board, he is placing his ADS right between the 2 windows, which you cannot generally shoot unless you take control of the kitchen or you have to clear it. And just to be clear to anyone who doesn't know what we're talking about, an ADS, from placed by Jaeger, also known as the trophy system, is going to be something he sticks on the wall or the floor that can catch up to 2 throwables. So having 3 flashbangs on an operator means if there is 1 ADS in the room and you throw all 3 flashbangs, the third one going clear, sailing clear into the room, lets you know that the ADS is now down because it has burned the 2 charges it can burn, and lets you know you are now clear to throw more valuable resources like grenades into the room.
Now, one thing I do want to clear out, I did say that FaZe are all in Sao Paulo. I will also add the fact that there is a massive thunderstorm going on as we speak in Sao Paulo and in the state of Sao Paulo, which, you know, has like 26 million people. But still, that might be a an explanation to why we've been having those. So
yeah,
it's not PCs or anything like that. It does make a ton of sense. Just so you guys are kept up on everything, I did check the weather.
There you go. You finally did it. Mid-game instead of during the break, too.
Yeah. Right. It's just more content.
Absolutely.
So, Team Liquid with Palu, who's playing as Plusifer here.
Already taking a little bit of damage, too.
Yes. I'm not sure if that was team damage or not. Maybe just running through is just a tiny bit of damage. Yuna will use his second Adrenal Surge, as we saw the first one being used early on to clear out the tower and anything in and around it. And he's just going to fire in to destroy the windows. Cameraman set up on the outside grenade will get used.
Okay, so looks like they did clear the ADS. And good use of the Thermite again, getting a kill. This time on a Nesk, and there's the Jaeger himself down, so he cannot replace that ADS.
And I'm not sure if that was Nesk trying to play from below in the tower and fight against Moringa, but hey, the Thermite winning the fight is definitely something that you're looking for. That's as the same piece.
So no, they had the Maverick bringing the flashes to clear the ADS. Yeah. That is, I mean, there's only a couple operators with smokes. That seems, again, like an odd choice, but this is a region that might not be as feeling as dependent on smokes to go for a plant here.
Mm-hmm. And obviously, when you bring the Maverick, he's gonna be running the flashes, right? There's no smokes anymore.
That's true. What was I thinking? Yeah.
That was only back
I was thinking in the early days, yeah. It was me wishing he had smokes, yeah.
No, thank God he doesn't, actually.
Yeah, no, I mean, as a player, not as a
cameraman
spectator.
Just walks in, he'll get kill, take down Paulo, and Gohan finishes off cameraman with a camera. Ironically enough, 3v3 as Sexy Cake is taking a ton of damage. Yuna will get the finisher on Zig to take him out. No Adrenal Surges left for the Finca player here. FaZe Clan try to fight in the hallway. Diffuser has been set, and now 3v2 actually turns into 2v1. Moringa will get one spray in the back of Gohan, and just so many bunks just hitting them, and the LMGs will just trade fire until one is victorious. In this case, that'll be Yuna. Put FaZe Clan on the board 4-1.
Gotta love the LMG versus LMG finale there. That's the way to do it. But finally one for FaZe. Despite all the problems, I mean, 2 of those from disconnects, 2 of those from actual losses. Now, finally, bringing it back a little bit on the attack before they get to go on the defense, in which, assuming no further disconnects, they might be able to bring it back. Different case. But Zig, I gotta imagine probably just teasing the Clash, not actually gonna bring it. Most likely 6 pick. There we go. Astro also going to do a six pick as well, but Zig going to be switching off to the Mira. And they're going to try dorms one more time. As well, that makes sense because, well, you can't go back to laundry and you probably don't want to go back to dining so much.
Yeah, very true. Even though they did win it.
Attackers yeah, need to but locate it's, and defuse you kind of showed what you were doing on
yeah,
it.
Yeah, you
so.
Showed your hand in that case. And
although, to be fair, had they won dorms, they would have had to probably go back to that or tower. So they wouldn't have much choice then. And that was what I was talking about in the system where
so
now...
So you're saying that they lost it on purpose?
Absolutely, yeah. That's the only possible explanation. Okay. So we'll see if this time somehow Maverick magically has smokes. those brain farts sometimes.
Yeah, I can't wait until a certain video that you and I made in Rio comes out. There's a lot of you forgetting
10
things.
10 seconds left before insertion.
Yeah. Not looking forward to that.
Everybody's been seeing the stuff that, you know, like Rogue and, you know, even with Zoronic and Wilkie. Well, we
to be fair, that was right after I beat my brain was mush.
Yeah, I mean, for people that don't know, Devin is diabetic, so.
Yeah.
There's something to keep in mind.
You had a slight advantage there,
slight. Yeah, but I think the points were very much in my favor.
Well, you're the lore fanatic.
For Warhammer, yes. Not for, anyways. You guys will get to see that later
yeah.
on, hopefully, if the video
there's there. Quite a few of them, so it'll be trickled
yeah.
out.
Maybe one day it'll be released.
Oh, you see the window being
tower.
Open. There, he's going to boost himself just to give himself extra recoil advantage on that fight, because, well, at long distance, you don't want the extra recoil, so smart, but fortunately, it's just going to get burned. Thankfully, he has three.
Yep, and of course, the adrenaline surges in the past used to last much longer than they
yeah.
do now. Now they're only 10 seconds. So,
it's
you know,
for the best.
The big trade was, hey, at least you get frag grenades. And on top of that, you're not as hurt by smoke, so it takes an extra tick of a smoke canister to kill you.
I feel like it has, in some ways, increased Figa's pick rate, but very, very slowly.
Yeah, it's before it wasn't... the whole pick around her was the adrenaline surge. Now it's more like a situational thing. It's not something you're going to use actively, you know, for big pushes, etc. But you can still chain them very efficiently.
Yeah. Either way, you'll often see one or two early in the round, and then save ones for them. But it's not just about pushes, also about being able to pick up a teammate occasionally.
True.
Just very rare.
It does happen, and I have to commend the... Oh, boy. Yep.
Well, I think that might be the end for FaZe. We'll find out soon, hopefully. But despite their one round win they managed to get, that is definitely going to be not good for them, as it's very likely, even if that doesn't count in a loss, it most likely will count in a loss of a round. Which
it should.
Yeah.
It would be potentially the third rehost, which should count as a loss. Because
yeah. I'm just saying either way, it's not good yeah. for FaZe.
Obviously,
so.
don't listen to us just yet. We're waiting until our admin.
Yeah.